Okay, hello everybody, and once again, welcome back to a not live stream of Talon. I was thinking, I'm gonna look, but we might actually keep going on the main quest. I do want to do the Jaws of Akan DLC, but I kind of want to do that one on live stream because it's more of a, you know, running around, doing stuff, you know, picking up pieces and whatnot, so, but... And I've never live streamed it, and it's a cool area, so I'd like to do that. Maybe show some people who haven't played that cool little spot. But my eyes kill me all of a sudden. But yeah, I think we'll keep going. I actually think it'd be kind of interesting to do Hakan after the main game, because there's something that I want to call him Avalas, but what's his Ameridan says. To you at the end that I think is really interesting, and it's sort of fitting for before the battle with Corypheus, but I think more so it's almost more fitting for after everything's gone down, and it's similar to the situation Ameridan was in, you know, where like his Inquisition was done, but then he had one more demon to fight, you know what I mean? So that's kind of what our situation's gonna be. So I think we're gonna do that. Also, somebody mentioned that they would like to maybe see me do the other... Whoa. I mean, I know we've looked at it, but man, it's really colorful in here now. I saw online, somebody actually posted a picture that they painted their walls in exact... like, their bedroom wall in an exact replica of the of the murals that Solas paints here. So if you guys... If you can, like, if that really vague thing right there will give you any hints, you should try looking it up. It was really, really cool. I liked it. Oh, shoot. We have to talk to everybody, though. We have to talk to everybody. All right. Today's talking.
Why did you do it?
I forgot.
I warned you not to.
No, you didn't.
Solas.
You gave yourself into the service of an ancient elven god.
You wouldn't have been happy if, freaking Morrigan had done it.
What does that mean, exactly?
You are Mythal's creature now. Everything you do...
You were once,
whether you
too!
Whether you want or not will be for her.
Is that describing Solas right there? Did he sort of release himself from this servitude of Mythal? Because I feel like he was, like, he was bound to her in some way before. Right? And now he's not? Or is he still but doesn't quite know it?
You don't even believe in the ancient elven gods.
I don't believe they were gods.
Oh, I think
no,
I did that last time.
I believe
time,
that
dang
they
it
existed. Something existed to start the legends. If not gods, then mages. Or spirits.
Ah.
Or something we've never seen.
He's trying so hard
you
to not spill the beans.
One of them now.
But
I
also trying to give me a hint.
You have the power than Corypheus. Which leads to the next logical question.
This is important, I think, this next part.
What will you do with the power of the well once Corypheus is dead?
I think I said I'll restore what was with Erica. But what would Talon want? I feel like he might also want to restore what was, but Talon is more, I think, a little bit more of a forward-thinking Dalish El. He respects the past, and he would take an arrow, like I said, he'd take an arrow for any of his people, you know? But he's a little bit up, I think he's a little bit more miffed, a little bit upset that, like, the Dalish now just seem content almost to wallow in, you know, what they lost, you know? And he's like, you know, we need to remember the past and respect it and learn what we can, but we also need to make a life for ourselves in the City Elves. Like, we need to make a life for all of us. We can't stay stuck in the past, you know? So, maybe, I mean, that sounds like a little bit idealistic, but, like, I'll make the world a better place, but it's also extremely, extremely, extremely interesting in this context talking with Solas, because every single thing you can say here has some sort of context in what his overall goal was. What's Solas trying to do? He's trying to restore what was. What was Solas trying to do? He was trying to make the world better. You know, what also did he do that brought him to a bad place? He relied on those he trusted. And then he was burned by that. You know what I mean? Like with the Evernurse, he trusted them at one point. Obviously, he trusted Mythal. And he was burned by that. One thing at a time, not quite sure how that one would work out. But I'm pretty sure all the things in here almost encourage Solas to continue on the path that he's on with the remaking of the world yet again. You know what I mean? So,
I
I'm trying to think. I kind of wish I had a better idea of what each outcome was. Maybe I might try to look it up, because I'll make the world better is one thing. I'll rely on those I trust is another one, but at the same time, I'm not quite sure. So, let's see. Okay, I think I like, from what I can tell, I think I like the, I'll make a world better. By the way, the video, it's hard to find one that gives you all dialogue options into the situation. It's by, Onforth143. It's the Solus Romance-Post Well of Sorrow Scene-All Options. So if you're interested, go check that video out. Sometimes I go through and I'll, like, do all the options, you know, but I think in this case I'll just not do that at this point. I might do it in my... eventually with a if I eventually ever get to my full playthrough of Erica again, but Andromeda's coming out in a month, so I might have to save that when we get better, when we get more concrete announcements on when Dragon Age 4 comes out, which if you haven't seen, you should go check Mark Dara's Twitter, because freaking he posted, they keep saying nothing's confirmed, but he posted some concept art. A concept art, like, in a book. It was in book format. And it is not any... That art was not... I have the art book for Dragon Age Inquisition. That art was not in there. It's brand new concept art. And it's definitely Tevinter styles for all species, races, whatever, cultures. It's amazing. Plus, there's, like, a blurry photo. And then there's, like, the Solus and the female Lavellan tarot card kind of mashed together that he always posts because he's teasing Solus at that. These people are gonna kill me someday. I like this one.
This war proved that we can't go back to the way things were. I'll try to help this world move forward.
You would risk everything you have in the hope that the future is better. What if it isn't? What if you wake up to find the future you shaped is worse than what was?
Isn't that intense? Like, and I'll bet you, because Solus said that first they were, like, you know, generals. There was a war, as there always is, you know? And at first the Evanirs, they were generals, and then they were kings, and then they were gods, you know? So is that the exact same sentiment that Solus had at one point? That he's like, this war proves, you know, that we can't go back to the way things were. And so he was trying to change things that way, almost as an Evanirus, almost, basically. Because he keeps saying, you know, like... It's difficult to decide whether or not Solus was actually a god before the Dreadwolf moniker, if he was the Dreadwolf beforehand, or if it was only the Dreadwolf after, you know, the Evanirus were like, he's a bad dude, don't talk to him, you know, type thing. It's difficult to tell when exactly that happened and if the Dreadwolf was a good thing or a bad thing, you know. It seems like he was a good thing because his, he had that shrine in Mythal's temple, right? So, like, he was obviously a very important person to Mythal. And so it seems like he was probably in good with the Evanirus, but he's also in good with the Forgotten Ones. We can't forget that. I think it was the Forgotten Ones. The Forbidden Ones are the demons. But yeah, so there's just a lot. This scene right here is very key. And this right here, if you wake up to time, the future shape is worse than what was, you know? And these all three of these options are like, it's just, it almost encourages Solus. It's pretty intense. We'll go with...
Yeah. You've done all right so far. We'll have problems, yes, but we can handle them.
Such confidence.
What's the alternative? Do nothing? We have to keep trying.
You're right. Thank you.
See?
For what?
You have not been what I expected, Inquisitor. You have impressed me.
Oh, wait, there's a mouse. Oh, quick, go away, mouse.
That if one keeps trying, even if the consequences are grave...
Look at... See?
Someday... Things will be better.
And that's basically just encouraging Solus to keep going.
This has cost us much. The Temple of Mythal did not deserve such a fate. The orb he carries, and its stolen power. That, at least, we may still recover. With luck, some of the past may yet survive.
Like, wow, like, basically there's nothing you can say there's nothing you can say, even if you've got a high disapproval with him, there's nothing you can say that will dissuade him from his path. Basically what you said right there is, even if things are bad, we'll keep trying. We will keep trying. And Solas is like, ah, because that's what Solas is doing, right? Solas tried to fix things when he was one of the Avengers. Then he cast them out and made the Veil to try to make things better. But the Veil didn't make things better. And he woke up 2,000 years later and things were apparently, according to him, worse than what they were before. And so he's like, oh, crap, you know? And now he's going to try and fix things again, basically. And basically what the Inquisitor is saying is, yeah, yes. Like, even if things are bad, keep trying, keep trying. But none of us can comprehend the keep trying on the scale that Solas is capable of, you know? Like, for us, it's politics and battles and diplomacy and you know, individual action, like, and group action type thing. But for Solas, he's one person with the snap of his fingers at any, perhaps not yet, but when he takes Mythal's power, at the snap of his fingers, Solas is able to reshape the world, basically. Perhaps not the snap of his fingers, but he is extremely powerful. And he's capable of changing the world on a scale we can't even comprehend. He's capable of actually changing matter itself. And we cannot... At this point, nobody in Thetis can comprehend that scale. You know what I mean? And it's very, very, very interesting. Something else I was reading online again that I really, really liked, and I don't know if I've mentioned it before... if I've mentioned it, because I just read it recently, but it said, it was talking about Redcliffe, right? So if you go save the mages and you go to Redcliffe, it's a future that was never supposed to happen, right? And basically, all the Inquisitor says the whole time when they meet up their companions who are stuck in there, and they meet Leliana and everything, basically everything you can say is, I'm sorry, this future wasn't supposed to happen, I'll fix it, I'll make it right, we'll go back, it won't happen. And Leliana tells you, she's like, no matter what you do, she's like, this future happened. She's like, to you, this is something that wasn't supposed to happen. She's like, but it did. There was pain and death and sorrow. And she's like, and destruction. She's like, you cannot erase that this happened. You can go back and make sure it doesn't happen in another future, but it happened in this one. You know what I mean? And I thought that was really poignant. But the whole time, the Inquisitor is saying, this wasn't supposed to happen. This wasn't supposed to happen. I'm so sorry. I'll fix it. I'll go back and fix it. What's Solas trying to do? Right, basically, it's exactly what Solas is trying to do. It's a smaller scale. It's a smaller scale for the Inquisitor. It was only a year, and it was like time-traveling magic that Solas didn't probably have, you know, and wasn't really aware. It was not really a thing that they had back then, or that they knew enough to not bother with, you know, or type thing. I mean, maybe because the fact that the breach was there made the Veil, made the time magic possible. So maybe they did have time magic. Who the frick knows? But anyway, what Solas is saying is this future... right now, currently, we're in right now, wasn't supposed to happen. It wasn't supposed to be this way. I can fix it. I can go back and I can fix it. Eh? I'm like making this face at the screen. I'm like, eh? You know, like, isn't that really interesting though? Like, on such a small scale, the Inquisitor experienced what Solas experienced. You know what I mean? And what Solas is trying to do. Again, only if you pick the Redcliffe mages, and in this one we went to Templars. But it was very, very interesting to read that. I was like, oh, that's a really big eye-opener on what Solas is doing, you know?
You planning to leave before we take down the bad guy?
No, but there may not be a later. It seemed wise to say my goodbye.
Oh! So he wasn't lying there, because Talon's like, are you planning on leaving? Are you planning on leaving before we take down the bad guy? And Solas is like, no, I'm not planning on leaving before we take out the bad guy. I'm planning on leaving after. So do you have anything else? My friend! Okay.
We'll talk later. Goodbye.
I do wish they had been given more options to talk about things. I don't know. For everybody, not just Solas. Whoop. Whoop.
So, I'm still trying to wrap my mind around this. We went to an ancient rune where you consumed a pool of elven...
Elfiness.
And then walked through a mirror and wound up back here. Have I mentioned that the shit that happens to you is crazy? I don't want to think about this anymore. You want to discuss something normal?
Oh, we haven't
done that
yet.
Tell me more about Bianca.
I'm not making any promises here. Ask.
Whoa.
So how long have the two of you been together?
Well, if you want to split hairs, we're not. Usually there's a continent between us at all times. We write letters. Now and then we manage to meet up. I don't know if that's together. Shit, it's been, what, 15 years? Great. Now I feel old.
Wow, that's... really? Jeez.
How do you know Bianca? The lady, I mean, not the crossbow.
I met her years ago when she still lived in Kirkwall, and I was looking for someone with mechanical skills. Bianca is, beyond a doubt, the most brilliant smith you'll ever meet. I haven't seen her since she got married and moved to Orlais.
Bianca is married? Somehow I thought that the two of you had a history.
Bianca's family are Kalnas. Surface dwarves, so conservative they don't take a piss without asking the ancestors first. They picked out a smith cast boy for her. Wealthy, respected, has a great anvil collection. The perfect husband. I heard the wedding was lovely. The one Bianca actually showed up for, anyway.
She did not show up to the runaway that they had planned, that her and Varric had planned.
What makes the Merchant's Guild such a danger to her?
Well, to be fair, it's more of a danger to me. Technically, we're not supposed to be within 300 leagues of one another. If it got back to the guild that we were seen together, they'd freeze my assets and then have me killed. Maybe not in that order.
What in the world did you do to cause that?
We almost started a clan war. Does it matter? I can't change it now.
Yeah, back in the day.
All right, tell me the truth. Bianca made your crossbow, didn't she? I mean, it has her name.
It's not that simple. The Carta thinks my Bianca was a freak success by a Carta inventor who could never duplicate it. If they thought anyone else was involved, someone who could make one work, things would be bad. So, I really can't tell the story. I don't want any more blood on my
It was
hands.
Two people, I think, we learned in Dragon Age 2. It was Bianca and that other
guy.
I guess
that's it for now.
Sure.
Who we meet in the DLC.
I'll be here.
So... I don't think I have anybody to judge. Look how full it is. Whoa. Oh, wait. I was talking to... I talked to Dorian, right? Did I talk? Yeah, because I was right next to him. And he didn't have anything to say. Oh, he did. That's right. We ran and talked to Dorian. So let's go. Whoa. Yeah. I can still do that. It's a strange quest to be given. I don't know. It is fun to try and find him, though. Let's go talk to Vivian. Whoop.
It's been quite the momentous day, hasn't it, my dear? How do you feel? It's not every day one absorbs ancient elven magic.
It was strange at first, but I think I'm all right now.
Good. We can't have you falling to pieces on the eve of such an important battle.
Thank you, Vivian.
The pieces are nearly in place. We'll soon strike against Corypheus directly. You've done well. I will be proud to fight alongside you when the time comes.
I really wish we could see more of them on the battlefield type thing, you know? And now, I don't know if it's because of now or if we had... I think we might have had access to it right after the Alluvian. But, like, right after the Alluvian thing. But I'm not sure if we've been through here. But we can access these rooms now. Not really sure why. There's really nothing in here. There's like a couple codex entries in a couple of them. But it's just a big, giant, empty castle. Like, it's very strange. What?
I return, Inquisitor.
Oh, it's the Quizquisition guy! Hi!
It begins now.
Yay!
A blight is signaled by the rise of an archdemon.
I'm so ready for this.
A corrupted old
Arthemiel! Arthemiel!
The archdemon of the fifth blight.
Special? Okay, ready?
The creature's name was Arthemiel.
Correct.
Yee!
The Quizquisition?
What?
Is complete.
It's complete!
And you have done so.
The boon of the spoon?
You may have an inadequate grasp.
Inadequate.
Quizquisition. Away.
This guy is so funny. I wish he would poof away though, like a little spirit, and I'd be like, what? Okay, what is that? What is the boon of the spoon? What the heck? Oh, I have so many things I haven't done yet. We'll sell that. Sell that. Boon of the spoon. What? It's a spoon that was hewn by a madman with a rune. I'm immune, he would croon, celebrating all too soon. He'd impugn in the poon, thinking fate so pecune. A tycoon made buffoon by one stricter than the cune. What did Mama say about rhyming? Mama said you'd get the spoon. I've never seen this. Target, 24% stagger on hit, A plus 8 willpower, and target explodes for 75% of damage. Wow. Fireball! Bull! I know it's not as good. Hang on, let's see. The damage is not as good, but wait, I gotta see him wear it. Oh my gosh, it's an actual spoon! What even is this? Is so funny! Now you need to do Trespasser, you can get like the... Or no, where is it? You can get the cheese... I mean, those are like the sad shards. Didn't I make those? Like the cheese shield, and then... Or no, yeah, the cheese wheel shield, and then there's a ham bone sword that I... Or is it the beehive one? There's like a beehive one, I think, too, in Trespasser. Oh my gosh, that is so funny. I love it. I love it. Staff of... Oh, that's right, we got the staff of... Oh my god! Oh, that makes sense! That makes sense! Oh my gosh! That we get the staff of corrupt... That's Orsino's staff. Wow! Okay, because we get Meredith... Okay, that makes sense! We get Meredith's sword. We get certainty, which is Meredith's sword if you fight Samson. But if you fight Calpurnia, you... Well, not fight. It turns out we just talk with her. You get the staff of corruption! Oh, cool. Let's see. This is sort of what I think, 2% chance to cast fear on hit. Nice. 62 electricity damage. It's not as good, but I don't care. If they call us corrupt, let us be corruption. Let us spread across the land a darkness from which they will not awake. Let us turn brother against brother while we laugh from the shadows. The Venator will destroy this land from within until a new Tevinter emerges stronger than ever. I think that the if they call us corrupt, let us be corrupt is kind of what Orsino ends up saying at the end. You know, like, we basically Orsino gives up in a really weird turn of events. I did not like the way that turned out. Meredith made sense. What happened to Orsino did not, but I really love the way Dorian looks. And the Staff of Corruption is beautiful! Can I get the schematics for it? Freaking heck. Maybe I'll check my bucket that I got, my little bucket thing that I have. These are all my bows. That would be significantly better than what I'm currently having, but freaking, I don't wanna. This one's cool. Longbow of the Griffin, like, it's Garahel's bow. Like, that's so cool. And Dal Valasan, also super cool. Doesn't look cool, but it's really cool anyway. And then there's that one, which is basically cheating with how good it is. And Talon's Dragon that I made that it looks the coolest out of all of them. But the Longbow of the Griffin actually matches my current armor a little bit better. Can I get a schematic for that one? Toss that. Armor. Let's see. Iron Bull. Does this... Oh. It's too bad I can't have... Oh, Bull would totally love the Ardent Blossom. That's too bad that I can't have him wear it. Battle Mage Coat. Yeah, toss that. Okay. Accessories. Let's see if we just have anything that we picked up that we don't need. Yeah. Oh, we're keeping it for sure. Toss those, toss those, toss those. Poison, Spinning Blades, Toxic Cloud. Toss that. I think everybody's basically good to go. Oh, do you? Oh, you only have that? Oh, shoot, girl. Shoot, girl, let me give you something better. Amulet of Strength. Superb Amulet of Cunning. Eh, I don't want to give that to you. Give her the Victim of Fashion. I'm going to give her the Victim of Fashion because I don't bring her out, so she's not going to die, so it'll be okay. But that is so funny. Oh, man, Vivian gets Victim of Fashion. I'd like to make something. I think Cole's armor is actually... It's something I can't remember. Oh, and I should maybe... Too bad I don't bring Varric out. I just never really see the point in upgrading his stuff. Because I don't bring him out. Sorry, buddy. Sorry. Well, cool. That was cool. We finally finished the... Somebody actually asked me the other day if I'd finished the quiz... If I'd heard of the Quizquisition and finished it. And I was like, I've never finished it. I've found it on... Did that... I found it on several characters, but I've never finished it. But there we go. Opa! Oh, yeah, the other side. Cool, cool. Alright, so we talked to Vivian, Varric. We talked to Leliana now. Go up. Try to not forget anybody. We can't forget Cassandra. Oh, let's turn in this. Yay.
You are a quick learner. Be careful.
Will do. All right, Leliana. Let's have the scary conversation. Oh, okay, well, there's that.
I was pondering who might be divine, and it suddenly occurred to me. Is it so ridiculous for the Grand Clerics to support me? Why shouldn't they?
If you were divine, what would you do?
Change things. Change everything. No more circles. The mages will be free. The Chantry will accept them as the Maker's children. In fact, it will accept everyone. Elves, dwarves, even Canari. Why exclude them? The Chantry allows our differences to tear us apart, instead of teaching us how we are the same.
I think last time I said you shouldn't be divine because I was hoping that it wouldn't be between Cassandra and Liliana, but I think in this case, her goals are, they kind of align with Talon's. Maybe I could support both her and Cassandra. But I'd like to try to kind of keep an even running and see what my actions will have done. Because it'd be interesting to have Vivian as divine. But I don't know. But at the same time, I don't really like Vivian's platform. So we'll go
I think you would make a good divine.
I am glad to hear it. Your support may persuade the Grand Clerics to vote in my favor.
And she's the only one who actually wants to be divine, you know, for good reasons.
In my years at Lothering's Chantry, we turned no one away from our doors. It was a refuge, a place of peace. I felt the Maker's presence and his love even when they told me he'd left us. This is the Chantry I know. The Chantry I wish the world to see.
Mm-hmm.
The Chantry you describe is vastly different from the one I know.
But it could be this way, could it not? The Chantry dictated where it should have inspired. It spoke of judgment instead of acceptance. It should encourage the good in everyone, rather than rebuke us for our sins. No one should be turned away from our doors. No one is without worth. Whoever you are, whatever your mistakes, you are loved.
This is different.
Unconditionally.
Because she's
in your heart
softened.
Shall burn an unquenchable flame.
I think it's different. Unless I've just taken a different route-ish, you know?
So if we kill Corypheus, he has the power to move from one tainted creature into another?
What, I love her armor, too.
That he can command the sun to rise or the seas to burn?
Can we prepare for flaming seas? Maybe collect all the snow from the frostbacks just in case.
I have researchers scouring the temple of Mythal.
Oh, shoot, so we did end up doing that.
I hope that their search turns up something we can use.
I wish we could kind of control that.
Something even Corypheus missed. Anything to give us an edge.
I kind of wish we could be, like, offering it to the Dalish elves as, like, a peace offering, sort of. I really, really wish that Inquisition, and, like, I've been reading a little bit about this lately, but it's something that's been kind of on my mind for a really long time. Ever since I played Origins, it's been kind of bubbling back there. But, like, I really, really wish that Inquisition had done something similar to Origins. Like, I read somewhere someone was like, I wish they'd done something like Mass Effect 3's endgame. And I was like, well, Mass Effect 3, yeah, I can see that, but to be more, you know, lore-friendly, to be more in the series, I think Origins would be better, which is very similar to what Mass Effect 3 did, where, like, your decisions actually matter throughout the game, and in the end, you can call upon allies, Origins, you can actually call upon allies. In Mass Effect, they all just show up, you know, which is cool. That would be cool, too, if they could have just shown up, you know. It would have been cool to see more wardens running around fighting for it, or seeing the consequences of the wardens having been with us, like, seeing maybe the wardens, like, or hopefully, in this case, we could decide whether or not to deploy the wardens or to keep them at home. Like, in this instance, we could maybe say, hey, wardens, stay and guard the castle, you know, while we're out, type thing. But you could see more Templars, we could see some Dalish elves, you know, if you're Kunari, maybe see your mercenary group or something. Like, I understand that they keep some of this stuff open for, like, headcanons and stuff, like, they don't want to dictate exactly how, like, this person looks or that person looks or whatever, but it would have been cool to, like, see, you know, at least, you know, representatives from our clan or something, representative from various Dalish clans coming to help us, and to even be able to call upon them in the final battle would be epic. And that just, it kind of tells me that, like, the final battle with Corypheus isn't as epic as it could be, because one dude and, like, their friends could, like, take on this big, huge, you know, behemoth with a giant dragon. Although we do get a little bit of help, you know, with that, with the dragon, but still.
Anything I should know?
It's been a long road, but we're nearing the end.
Yes, we are.
Campania's loss has left the Venatori demoralized. They'll be easy to eliminate.
Is she still alive?
I'll leave you to your work.
That's a very important question to me. Is she still alive? Okay, we'll go talk to Blackwall, and then Cassandra. I'm actually really mad at Cassandra. She was very rude, I feel like, in the temple.
Inquisitor?
Oh, we haven't done this yet.
Rhaenyra or Blackwall?
I've gotten used to Blackwall. Perhaps we could treat it as less of a name and more of a title. Almost like Inquisitor. Reminds me of what I ought to be.
Everyone needs something to aspire to.
Exactly. I'm glad you understand.
Is there anything you actually know about the Wardens, or did you make it all up?
I made very little up. I also feared you knew enough to contradict me. Warden Blackwall told me a bit before.
Leliana would have known enough to contradict him, if nothing else.
Not even the most senior Wardens know all there is to know.
I'm thinking about getting a mod eventually where, like, during these kind of dialogue scenes, there's a mod that zooms up on the conversation, which makes it seem more cutscene-like, and I think I might get that, just because it is a bit weird to be so far away.
Now we know why you were never worried about Corypheus's calling.
Yes. I have none of the Warden's abilities.
Oh, man, I remember learning it. This just broke my heart with Erica.
Still.
Broke my heart.
I would have fought through the darkest pits of the deep roads like any true warden.
He would have. I don't doubt that. There's more to it than being able to sense darkspawn. And I just didn't like how, like, you're very aggressive. Like, your default is to be aggressive to Warden. Like, to Blackwall. Like, you can be like, I understand. And then you're like, well, now we know why you never heard the call. And blah, 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 you know?
The Wardens at Adamant listened to you. They saw you as
well. Why didn't any of the Wardens not recognize
you? It takes an outsider to show how much of yourself you've lost. I never understood the reality of being a warden.
At the very least, some of these senior wardens should have been like, that's not Warden Blackwall.
You have a lot of respect for the wardens.
They take all men, from the most noble to the most despicable.
I'm about to crack open a soda.
And make them equals. I needed to believe something like that was possible.
Why did Blackwall want to recruit you?
I don't know what he saw that day besides some wreck starting a bar fight. That night, I taught some village militia a painful lesson about harassing the tavern girl. Didn't know I had an audience.
Mm-hmm.
It's obvious he recruited you for your skill in battle.
Was probably just curious how some filthy vagrant could cut down so many militiamen. I didn't ask. And I suppose we'll never know.
I don't know, I think he saw something in Blackwall worth saving. He probably saw a lot of pain on Blackwall, and he recognized it, probably. The Wardens are... they are very flawed, but many of them are very... they're good people. I mean, in spite of and perhaps because of their flaws, you know? And they recognize pain and suffering in each other, you know? And in other people. They see it, and they know... they just know. And he also saw how he fought, you know, and he knew that probably Blackwall had something he was hiding from or running from. Probably even a lot of it was probably saw that Blackwall didn't have much left to lose, you know? And I think that's a really good thing to look for in a warden, is you don't, like, somebody not having a lot to lose, because I don't think it's fair to recruit wardens who have, like, families and stuff like that, you know? I think recruiting somebody who doesn't have much left to lose means that if they do die... sadly, I mean, as harsh as it may sound, then there's not a whole lot that's been lost. I mean, there has, but there is. Like, each person, like Ileana said, like, each person is worth, you know, an infinite amount, you know? But, you know what I mean, though? Like, there won't be, like, family being like, what happened, you know, type thing. It'll just be another warden And what I really like is that even if you take, even if you die during the joining, you're still listed in the annals as a warden. I really like that. Like, they're not just like, oh, you died. Yeah, forget you. History will forget you. Even if you know, time wears the monuments and the parchments down, like, at least your name will be inscribed somewhere for history, you know? I don't know. I like that.
We'll continue this another time.
One of the reasons in Origins I really liked finding it wasn't the DLC. When you're going to check out Bronca. And, Mother, I'm sorry it took so long to write. It's been hard, but we are getting new allies and new gear every day. The Inquisition is a grand thing to see, and the crew here are family. Alia, she wrote last time for me, has helped teach me my writing, so I'm faster. I'm learning so much here. I know I can use a dollar to start a stable at home. Father always said he wanted to get horses. With the money I'm paid, I can make a start. Alia says it's a good idea, and in her work, she has made some good feed that helps them grow. All we have to do is win, and you'll be safe, and Father will see what's worth it, and I can come home, and I can bring help. Your son, Desmond. I think we read the one before. I think I just tried to do the... I just tried to do some sort of... What did I just try to do? I tried to search using, like, the left trigger button, and I don't know why. Oh, hey, look at it. But... I don't know what I was saying before, but I got distracted by that, but I like the wardens. They're good people. They just make some really bad decisions sometimes.
Tiriffius is able to possess Grey Wardens.
Yeah, good thing you're not a Grey Warden, actually.
I'm not a real warden.
It's a blessing. Warden or not, I'd hate to be on the other side of your blade.
Indeed.
Going up against a darkspawn, and the last thing you want is a Grey Warden.
Isn't that crazy, though?
Funny how these things happen.
Yeah.
What do you think of the Inquisition?
I just know that you could shake this world to its foundations if you willed it.
Oh, man. The final bet. I'm trying to decide. Because I feel like Talon would legitimately be... I mean, he brings Cassandra along for her, like, her bluntness, you know? Like, he likes to kind of, like, stand kind of in the shadows and watch her, like, ream people, you know? Or he enjoys her very blunt, straightforward attitude. But I don't know how he'd feel about after the way she was incredibly disrespectful to the Elven Temple. She's like, how can they spend so much time on this folly?
You are, after all,
how much time and resources
charge
on this folly, you know, looking at the temple? And I'm like, are you joking me? Are you joking me? Freaking look at the chantry! Look at the freaking chantry! How much money do they spend on the Divine's gown? You know? How much money do they spend on the stupid, on everything? And you have the gall to say that? Oh my gosh. Ooh, I could get that. Is it any good? No, it's not. Anderfell's Green Men Warriors. The order began in his name. Leads caravans to the dangerous wandering hills to the distant port of Laish. And are comprised of the best marksmen in Thedas, and comprise the best marksmen. Is that the other way to conjugate that? Interesting. Mage hunter shield, cool. On hit, gain 3 guard. What? That's actually really cool. The third time the rite of annulment was with the rite invoked as the third, okay, tower in 309 Towers. Knight Commander Gervaso of Antiva killed all the city's mages for demonic possession. However, a massacre may have already occurred at the hands of Knight Captain, so the one below, Nicholas, with the rite invoked as a cover-up. The Seeker of Truth later apprehended Sir Nicholas, who had left the order to kill mages, and admitted to having murdered over 100. Well, great, that's exactly what I want somebody to be carrying around. But why would I want to... It's got really great perks, though. The on hit gain 3 guard alone is awesome. Anyway, I need to sell some stuff. Yep. Jeez. Where was it? I don't think I've actually done any of the upgrades for Skyhold. It just takes my plants away, and I don't want it to take my plants away. By the way, I need to make sure that that's good to go.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Hardy. I haven't talked to you this whole time.
Scout
I'm sorry.
Hardy.
Your worship.
Tell me about yourself.
Who's Scout Harding, really?
Me? Oh, I'm no one. Live near Redcliffe all my
She's
life.
She's so cute!
Her shepherded sheep for my neighbor. When the Inquisition came through my village, I helped by telling them everything I knew about the area. Then I signed on. Wanted to see the world before it was swallowed up by that thing out there.
Shouldn't you be out there scouting?
In a bit. We're in Skyhold for supplies and a change of personnel. Not me, though. Indispensable.
Indeed. I think it's really cool how at the end of Trespasser, Harding is there with you. You know what I mean? Like, I think that that's a very... I don't know if that was just done, like, in an offhand thing, or... Because I think it's Cassandra, Liliana, and Harding. Because, I mean, Cullen's taking a break. At least it appears that he's taking a break. He said he'll be there if we need him, but who knows if he's actually making a comeback. I think he does deserve a bit of a break. I also don't know if he'll be able to stay out of whatever shenanigans happens. You know, like, he's, you know, kind of that duty-bound, honor-bound type person. But I wonder... I bet you, because they usually have a repeat character, I bet you Harding is going to be the repeat character. I wonder, because I'm really hoping, like I've mentioned a billion times, that in the next game, we're just like a little tiny piece of the Inquisition, like a scout or a spy or something, some sort of vanguard maybe, sent to Tevinter to sort of scope out the land and maybe look for new recruits, basically. Like, we're from wherever, you know, we're from, and we've been sent out by the much reduced Inquisition to go find new people, because the goal of the Inner Trespasser is to find people that Solas doesn't know, so that Solas can't predict their actions as well, you know? So I'm hoping that, like, our Inquisitor, through Harding, like, speaks through Harding and kind of gives us messages, and maybe even Harding joins us. Like, Harding, maybe Harding is actually going to be part, not just, like, the liaison, but she'll be with us, like, one of the first companions that we get, you know? And that would be really cool. And then we'll go out, like, searching for new friends in Tevinter and maybe Saharon? Cross fingers?
What's been going on?
Secret Cassandra came through here looking like a storm cloud. That's just her normal face, look, though, isn't it?
Yep.
Take care.
I do like that in Jaws of a Con you can talk to her a lot more. Can I talk to you yet?
There is an issue that you should address. I think it's worth your time, Inquisitor.
Stop the rumors. Okay. I think last time I did Cullen's and it was really funny.
Inquisitor?
He hasn't said anything about my romance this time around.
Unlikely. What's the word out there?
Briala is pulling strings in your favor.
Going over as well as you'd expect.
Ooh, interesting.
As you were.
Last time he said something about, like the Inquisitor having time to bed somebody or something, and I was like, don't you judge me. It was really funny.
The Temple of Mythal.
Oh, really?
It's a crazy
fight. Well, why weren't you there? You weren't there? Where were you, Krem? Why couldn't we see the chargers, too? That would have been cool.
Can we talk about the
make sure we get this done.
Certainly. What can I tell you?
More interesting jobs.
Any other interesting jobs?
We went up against Gatla's giants in Ferelden. Not actual giants, but big guys. All wearing a dragon's weight and armor. Might as well be fighting golems. The chief challenged Gatla himself to a single combat. Gatla laughed and called him a horned savage. The chief broke a dam and flooded the valley. Last we saw Gatla was a bunch of bubbles as we swam away.
Wow! Interesting! What an interesting way to go about... See, that's the thing, is Bull, you can't underestimate Bull because he doesn't just, like, charge in and, like, sword swing in at everything, even though he loves a good fight, you know? Like... But he was willing to, like, he was not only willing to do, like, the single combat thing to prevent casualties, but then, you know, when it wasn't going to work that way, he had a backup plan. Like, and it didn't get anybody killed except the bad guys who were stuck at the bottom and they can't swim. Oh, that's awesome.
We'll talk later.
Let's see, is there anything else we could
do? Your worship.
Can you think of any other tasks suitable for the charges?
Most of our people were at the Temple of Mythal. I've still got a few, though. Men who are recovering from wounds. I can send them around to rattle swords, wave flags, and look a lot larger than they are. It'll mess with enemy estimates of our numbers, so no one thinks Skyhold is undermanned.
Oh, right.
Can we talk about the Bull's charges?
Certainly. What can I tell you?
Because most of our forces are still out there.
Have you had any other interesting jobs?
We had these villagers pay us with rice one time. Should have seen the
Oh my gosh, what a cute laugh!
Me and five guys defending the town from 50 bandits, and they pay us in bags of rice. She always took money up front after that. We also learned how to make this rice pudding dessert. It looks awful. It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. Oh, that's fantastic. I'm expecting a phone call from a possible job, so I might be a little bit distracted.
We'll talk later.
Inquisition numbers. Let's see. Okay, so that
was
it.
We'll talk later.
I hope Krem comes. I hope Krem's one of them that comes back too. Harding and Krem. Harding and Krem would be good ones to come back.
So to kill Corypheus, all we have to do is kill his dragon first? That's easy. We're good at killing shit. Just one more big fight to put this magister asshole down for good. I knew you'd get us here, boss.
I've been
waiting for the chance to pay that bastard back.
Yeah, this is gonna be fun.
I do want the zoom up thing. It's a little bit weird being so far away. Do we have anything else to say to you?
How you doing?
Nope, okay.
See you later, Bull.
Cole and Sarah now. I gotta be better friends with Sarah, though. Shoot. I wonder where I'm at with Sarah. Oh, she's gonna be mad, though.
You've been skittish for days. What's up your crawl?
Rude.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
It's nothing. It's just the figures.
Are my boys still out? I haven't been able to talk to them much.
You're still on about the champion. That's over and done.
The people on whom history pivots, their influence is felt even in their absence.
Right.
Yeah, dude.
Were you a philosopher or something useless like that?
Something like that.
What were you then? Was she a city elf? Because it's funny, because a lot of times elves are scripted to be put into the Dalish stuff. There's not really a city elf look, which is why, I mean, Briala was wearing Dalish elf armor, like we saw, you know? And every city elf, well, maybe in Orlais. I don't know if in Orlais if they were wearing Dalish stuff. They might have just been wearing armor. But it seems like in some cases, most elves are just scripted to have Dalish armor. But I like that in the Inquisition, they're given Inquisition armor, apparently. That's cool. Sarah's gonna be all like, oh no, she's not? What? I thought you were shooting arrows at the door.
Oh, hi, yeah. Listen, stand there.
Why do you have your bow on?
Now, about Mythal. Yeah.
Sarah, I don't know what reaction you want, but can this be it so we can be done?
All right. So maybe it's still you. Someone needed to do something. I mean, you went wading into a well of sorrows. Who hears that and thinks, well, dunk a butt, let's have a go.
Dunk a butt!
Even mad old Avalas said elves destroyed themselves. The only believable bit in a sea of clear demon bait. It makes messing with their relics real stupid. So, test done, you're still you. We can leave these lies behind.
I was aiming an arrow at my face a test.
I heard once that if you're possessed, the demon will defend itself against attack. Sounds stupid to say it out loud.
No.
I don't know. I don't know demons. At least if it's true, the arrow's right there. I'm sorry, yeah. Morrigan's probably got better ways, but who can trust her?
Why do we have to be so mean?
So your main takeaway is that elves worship demons.
Well, they never call them that, yeah? But that's what it had to be. I mean, it was impressive and all. Makes the Dalish look like tits for living in the woods, but so what? There can't be a bunch of gods and the Maker. Don't matter how much or little you believe, those don't fit. So call me stupid, but I believe the stuff not made up by dead people who failed. Mythal is a ruin full of demons. I mean, it just makes sense, right?
So the only option you have is to make her angry, apparently. Besides saying, I agree with all lies, and I don't. But what if even some of it is true? I know she disapproves. I believe all of it was true. She probably greatly disapproves. You're insulting our heritage. She probably greatly disapproves. What would Talon say? I almost think he'd want to be like, you're insulting our heritage. But at the same time, again, like, I feel like he would be upset by this sort of a thing, but he would keep it hidden, you know? Like, he wouldn't be, like, he wouldn't be visibly upset by it. So, we'll
There's so much history there. What if some of it is true?
No, now you're stupid. You can't think that because
But see,
stupid.
And she's saying this because
but
she's afraid.
We saw.
Why believe it? Because Abelas looked weird. If that's all it takes, Corifi's shitheel is full of lumpy truth.
Well, he might be full of truth.
You're an elf. Be all elfy. But this? You're the frigging herald of Andraste. Every time you open your mouth, you'll sound like an idiot.
I've said I'm not her herald. Oh, man, that's rude.
It's not as if it matters what I believe. I've already denied being the herald.
Not for me to say, yeah. Just saying. Anyway, believe what you want. So long as you kill the green fish. Whatever.
God dang, I don't know how to get Sarah's approval up to save my life. Can't we just disagree about this and still be friends? You know? Like, it doesn't make sense.
Naughty bloomers.
Oh, boy, is that me?
The thing's playing out so the way you
expected. Bloomers, I like that.
Everyone's ready to punch Corypheus in the dangle bag. That's what you call it. Metaphor.
What do you think about the people who have gathered?
Again, with your people. Mm-hmm. Right, which ones?
What does she say about Dorian?
What about Dorian?
You're having it off with him. You don't need me to talk him. But I do anyway.
Okay. Is it Solus change?
What about Solus?
Solus? His head's crammed up 1,000 years ago.
Okay, that's good for now.
We'll talk later.
Good, right?
I wish her opinions on them changed a little more verbally, like, throughout the game, you know? She updates Blackwall.
Your wish is something.
We allies.
What do you think about them?
Again, with your people. Right, which ones?
Blackwall.
Any thoughts about Warden Blackwall?
Right, Warden. Good liar, that one. Should give lessons. Suppose he kind of did. Soldiers do nasty shit. Still kind of like him, though. Proper sorry, him.
And for Sarah to say that, I think, is important. Like, of all the people, like, you know?
We'll talk
I wonder
later.
What Cole thinks of Good, right? Blackwall. I think he liked, because he knew from the beginning what Blackwall did, and Cole didn't hate him. So, yeah. Does this change? This might change. Bottle, Warden strong, Griffin, Warden heavy, her mask big head, his mask tight face, corset lacings, with the peculiar mustache, that's not a face. What? A doodle of a googly eyed face with a peculiar mustache, that's not a face! Is that supposed to be Dorian mustache? Her mask big head, his mask tight face. Interesting. I know in Trespasser, her little diary updates a little bit more. I like that she keeps a little diary. Oh, cool.
We all did.
Cool. What?
Corypheus died.
Oh, yes.
And then he didn't. That's why he always felt wrong. Like he didn't fit inside himself. He wears another man's life.
Ah.
I thought dying was forever.
It's hard for any of us to make sense of. Corypheus is using ancient magic.
But is it him? Is he real? If a man can be
this
dead.
This is more about Cole than
not,
Corypheus.
Could I have saved the real
no.
Cole?
What happened to him wasn't your fault.
His hands were bruised from beating on the wall. It was dark, like the cabinet where he hid to escape his father. His belly hurt like knives, throat cracked dry. He was alone. I pushed through and held his hand. It was all I could do.
He was a brand freaking new spirit,
he
you know?
Said, thank you.
And you made it so he didn't die alone.
Thank you.
If you make Colmore spirit. Whoa! Okay, cool. I was like, cool. Oh, and I love that we're still standing on the edge. That's awesome. If you make Colmore spirit, he makes himself forget, basically. That's Cole's. Colin's over here. Which may be very sad. That was one thing I don't really like about the spirit thing is that Cole makes himself forget. But sometimes you do have to forget to move on, you know? But in this one, it's Cole has to learn and grow and accept, which I'm so torn on what I want to be my actual canon Cole. Is that, I mean, do I want him to stay true to his original form? Spirit? Like, it seems cruel to make him more human, you know, in a way. I get to deal with the pain and the suffering in a human way, or a humanoid way, or whatever, you know? But to make him more spirit, I mean, he sort of became a human on accident, you know? But it's so interesting because we don't hear about that happening very often. And, like, Cole's whole situation is extremely, extremely interesting, especially considering the fairly benign possession stories that I think we have. In Origins, we have Wynn, who's benignly possessed by compassion spirit. We have Dragon Age 2, where Anders is possessed by Justice, and in a fairly benign way. But unlike Wynn basically embodied a spirit of compassion, and so she didn't change that spirit inside of her. You know, she didn't make it, she didn't change it. Whereas Anders had a lot of built up anger and like repression, and while he wanted justice, his anger twisted justice into vengeance. You know, and that ended poorly. You know. And then 3, we have Cole, basically, who is a spirit who made himself a body, you know? But we also, who is it, the possession thing, isn't there somebody who's, no, I can't think of anybody off the top of my head. I guess if you have Kieran alive, Morgan's son, is he possessed? Or he was born because of, well, no, he's not born because of, he was born, he was made, and then the spirit got inside of him somehow, I don't know. Can't wait to play with Kieran. Can't wait for that. Still haven't played with any saves. I also want to get a mod where I have access to multiplayer armors. Alright, wait. I think I saw something. No? You probably have a book up in your bedroom, huh?
Though all before me is shadow, yet shall the Maker be my guide. I shall not be left to wander the drifting roads of the beyond. For there is no darkness in the Maker's light, and nothing that he has wrought shall be lost.
A prayer for you.
For those we have lost, and those I am afraid to lose.
I'm glad you haven't lost your faith.
I've questioned it at times, but I found comfort in faith when life offered little. Corypheus will retaliate. It's only a matter of time. Must draw strength wherever
I don't
we can.
Like to demean people for their beliefs. If there was an option where you could be a little more like, you know, like, hey, like, I respect your beliefs, you know, and these are my... And that's the thing is, in this game, I try really, really hard to respect everybody's beliefs, you know, even though the Chantry has historically been very horrible to my people, to the Dalish, you know, and, I mean, depending on if you're a dwarf or a Qunari, the Chantry has historically been very rude and horrible. Not just rude, they've been very massacre-ish, you know, but... feel like it's not the Chantry, the Chantry itself is corrupt, but there are people within it that are good people. That's how it is in all walks of life. Like, there's always, like, an organization that people are like, oh, it's a bad organization, or some of these people are, or some of these, like, these big ones, these big people, they're bad. And it's like, you know what, each group has good people in it. And in fact, I'm pretty sure most groups, not, I mean, excluding, like, fanatic groups, you know, most groups have good people in them. And the organization itself often has good goals, or it started out with good goals, you know, but they get twisted by people, you know, but there are still good people who see the good that these organizations can do, you know, and if nothing else, having the Chantry in Talon's pocket would be beneficial, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, we're having Briala pull strings for us behind the scenes. Why not be in good with the Divine and have her pull strings for us, you know? And I feel like while Leliana is very similar to Briala, because Briala wanted change immediately, you know? And Celine said that couldn't happen. It had to be gradual, you know? And that's true. In many ways, a just abrupt change is going to cause upheaval, you know? And Cassandra, I think, is a middle ground where she wants to have change and everything, but she wants to do it in such a way that won't cause an intense upheaval. She wants to change things, and she's very straightforward about that. But I think she would be less inclined to drastic measures than Liliana would be. Like, she has the same goals as Liliana, but she's a little less okay with antagonizing people. But I'm not, they basically have the same end goal, so I think both of them would be good. The way I view Cassandra, even though I know she technically does fine as a divine, I feel like she would suffocate. She's a woman of action. She needs to be out doing things. She's a goes to, you know, recover the seekers, you know, build them into a force of good, you know. She's an on-the-ground type person. It's like Iron Bull says in the beginning that, like, Cassandra is more of a big picture, or she's not a big picture person. She's a small picture person. She looks for answers, similar to the Ben Hasrath, right? And whoever wrote Iron Bull's dialogue, by the way, is a freaking genius, because he says so many good things that I remember, especially in that beginning conversations with him. He just says so many things that have really stuck with me. Like, the one thing that I think of the most with Iron Bull is the conversation where he says, "My people don't choose a leader based on the strongest or the smartest. We choose leaders based on those who can make difficult decisions and deal with the consequences." And that to me is actually shaped even a little bit of my real life. You know, it's like, how would I choose a leader? You know, how do you choose a leader? It's like, there's so many different factors into it, but I think that that's a good thing to remember. You know, I don't know, just even in real life, it's interesting. So anyway, we must be prepared.
Are we prepared?
We will be. I should return to my duties. There's more to be done.
I think I already examined that and doesn't do anything. Pooped me out here. Morgan, you over here somewhere. Morgan, here you are. Yo.
I understand you are off to summon Mythal.
Hey, I also want to get a mod for Morgan, because as iconic as this outfit is, I don't think she'd be wearing this. Like, they went through really cool iterations of her concept art for this game, and I really wish they... Like, at first I was like, oh, it's fine, but the more I'm like... I mean, you know, hey, I don't know how old she is, like 40 or something. Like, you know, she's got the body, you know, flaunt it, show it off. It shows that she doesn't care, you know, what type of thing. But it's been 10 years since Origins. Do you really think she'd be wearing this after that much time? Like, I think she would have gone through some changes. You know what I mean? Like, everybody's gone through some changes, and I feel like she would have something similar to this, but it would maybe be just a tiny bit different. I'm not saying she doesn't look good in it, and I'm not saying that if you're over a certain age and a woman that you can't wear certain things, because frick heck yeah, man, even if you don't have the stereotypical body, wear what you like, wear what you want, be comfortable in it, be happy with yourself, it doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. But I do think that Morgan, at this time in her life, would not be... She's more subtle than she used to be. You know what I mean? Like, she's not so much, like, flaunting. She sort of sneaks in and then, like, blows everybody's minds that way, you know? Instead of just walking up and being like, you know? Like, she doesn't try to shock with her appearance as much anymore. I think she tries to be a little bit more subtle from the shadows a little bit and then show up and be like, haha, here's this thing that I have, or this knowledge, you know, type thing. And so, yeah. I do like this design, but I think if they'd have changed it just a tiny, tiny bit, it would have been cool.
She's a goddess.
And what is that exactly? I suggest you prepare yourself, Inquisitor. It will
Oh
no
boy, Morgan, you have no idea. You have no idea. Oh, God. I don't know if I'm going to ask this one.
You seem to know a great deal about elven lore.
The Dalish are not the only ones interested in the distant past, Inquisitor. Indeed, my skills allow me access to places the Dalish dare not even dream of. The ancient elves hold secrets they have not yet given up. Secrets about the foundation of Thedas itself. Thus, they are my focus. Corypheus clearly feels the same.
I'd like to know more about you.
If you have questions, then ask.
Okay.
I'll leave you to the garden.
Of course.
Yay! I believe that is everyone. Nope, Cassandra. I always forget Cassandra because she's... Oh, what? Michael, what?
It's good to know we're doing something worthwhile.
Oh, hey, I did not realize you'd be around. That's cool. I'm glad to see you. Cassandra. I believe that's everybody. We did everybody in the thing. Look. Look, we have a sentinel elf.
The temple?
I'm not listening.
One of our own entered, and one of our own emerged. The old ways remain.
Heretics and demons.
That's all that was.
This is so freaking hilarious because this guy is wearing Sentinel Elf armor and he's obviously like an Andrastian, and it's so weird. I love seeing the Sentinel armor, but if he was a Sentinel Elf, he's obviously not a Sentinel Elf, but he's wearing Sentinel Elf armor and being really like, you know, upset about the Dalish or the things that happened there in the Temple of Mythal.
Victory in the Arbor Wilds. The Archdemon might have been a real threat to our army, but it flew off once we turned the tide. It is still out there, however. I wonder what Corypheus plans now.
We'll deal with whatever he throws at us.
Do not underestimate Corypheus. He is powerful, and you have yet to fight him one-on-one. But he will come. You will get your chance.
You don't seem concerned about that.
I'm terrified. Yet I have faith in you.
Thanks.
Not long ago, this was impossible to imagine. You, a valued friend, victory close at hand. The time has come to consider what will come next.
Oh, I have plans of my own.
As you should. Blessed are they who stand before the corrupt and the wicked and do not falter. You have come far, my friend. It has been an honor.
I want Sarah to be friends with me! I haven't gotten the cookie, the rooftop thing yet. So I knew maybe before I do anything, I need to like freaking take Sarah out and do things that she'll approve of, because dang nab, I want to be friends with her. We can disagree about things and still be friends.
Inquisitor.
It upsets me that the game thinks I cannot, which is why I'm actually really looking forward to Andromeda, because apparently in Andromeda, you can express yourself a little bit more nuanced. And there will be like
it doesn't cover such things. It's all right to admit that.
You can't know. She has always shown us the way just because an elf found that temple.
A place of our people, led by one of our people.
Perhaps. Perhaps your old ways are not what we thought.
Why are you wearing Sentinel armor, guy? Just throws me off. Well, let me see. I'm gonna take some time, I think, to upgrade people's stuff and whatnot. Maybe I'll go buy some schematics. I don't know. And I don't have any. Oh man, that makes me so upset. Wait, let's check. Alright, so I am gonna probably call this part here anyway. I'll do some stuff in here, like potions and armors and stuff like that. I'll probably still bring Cassandra along because she's what I'm used to, but at this point with Talon. But yes. So anyway, thank you guys for joining me. I hope you're enjoying so far. I think we're gonna at least do the Temple of Mythal. We'll see about finishing the endgame and then going on to Trespasser and or going on to Hakan and then Trespasser. And Trespasser I will probably not stream. I might. We don't know. Let me know what you guys would think. Like, let me know what you guys think. If you want me to stream it or not. I'll probably stream Jaws of a Con just because it's, you know, something to do. But let me know what you think about streaming Trespasser, because it'd be interesting to see people's reactions, and I could plan ahead and like try to make it a time that like a lot of people could come, you know, a lot, like, I mean, we have a lot of people who show up anyway, but for more of you, if you're interested in coming and watching Trespasser and like sharing theories like live or whatever and everybody talking like, you know, together or like whatever, let me know if that would be cool or if you want me to just record it so that way, you know, it's not me being super distracted during, you know, during gameplay and stuff like that. But yeah, let me know what you think, and if you want me to stream, what times you think would be cool, or what days, or whatever. So yes, thank you guys for joining me with this one. I appreciate it very much, and I hope to see you next time. Thanks!